So let me deploy the server. And as I said, you can use Vultr or any VPS that you want to use. For me, I'm using Vultr. So if you want to deploy a server, just go there and deploy a new server. And I will be using Debian 10. So for this, you can use cloud compute or high frequency. And I'm going to use cloud compute for this. This is 20% more expensive than that. And they say this is much faster than that. So I'm going to use, let me choose a location in America. And I'm going to choose a location. I will choose the Chicago data center. And then the operating system, I want to install Debian 10. So I'm going to click there and then I will select Debian 10. And the server size, since I want to install Virtualmin, so since I want to install Virtualmin, I want something that at least has 2 gigs of memory. So I'm going to choose this one for 10. I'm going to choose the $10 server, which has at least 2 gigs of memory. And of course, I will enable IPv6. I don't have any startup scripts and I don't have the SSH key. I'm going to show you how you can set up the SSH key. And for the server hostname, I don't know which one to use. Let me log into Cloudflare and choose a domain that I can use. So for the server hostname, make sure you're using a name that is a fully qualified domain name. A fully qualified domain name, that's a name that you can access. If you add DNS records, it should be something that is accessible. You can use a full domain or you can use a sub domain. So if you want to, you can use something like a full domain like that, or you can use a subdomain, but in my case, I want to use a subdomain. So I'm just going to add here panel dot, that is the hostname, and this is going to get set up on Debian. If you want to change it, you can change the hostname on Debian using the terminal, using the command line, you can do that. But just make sure you set it up now, since we're going to install Virtualmin and our aim is to run a WordPress website, and we also want to be able to send mail, make sure that you have a subdomain that is a fully qualified domain name. So I'm going to add that as my hostname. And then for the label, you can use anything that you want. I'm just going to leave it as it is. And then let me just go up and see if there's anything I've missed. And everything is as I chose it. So I'm just going to click here and I will deploy my server. So let it finish installing. It's going to take a while, not even more than 5 minutes. Let's just click on it to see if it's already given us an IP address. Okay, not active. Just give it a few minutes and then we're going to come here, click on it, and we're going to get user root, and we're also going to get a password and an IP address, and you can use the IP address to log in. So let me click on it again and you can see now it is ready. So by the time you're watching this, I will have removed this server. I will have destroyed the server. So don't try to access it in any way. So if you want to see your password, you can click there to see the password. And you can copy it. You can copy your IP address and the root. The user is root. So you can log in. If you want to log in via party, there is a guide here how you can log in via party. But I want to log in using Git Bash. So I'm on Windows. I'm doing this tutorial on Windows. And you can use Git Bash if you want that terminal-ish environment. So if you are on Linux, Mac, you can still follow along with me because I will be using Git Bash. If you prefer to use Party, the tutorial is here, how you can set up your server using Party. And I'm going to follow some of those as well. So if you want to install Git Bash, just come to Google and you're going to search for Git. Let's just search for Git. And you want to download it from Git SEM. Come here and click on Downloads and then install, download the one for Windows. So I'm on Windows. I'm going to download the one for Windows. I already have it installed. I'm just showing you what you can do. So once the download is complete, this is going to install everything we need. It's going to install Git Bash. It's going to install Git, and it's also going to install Git CMD. So anything that you want to do with any of those others, you can do, but we are only interested in Git Bash. So once you install it, just go and open it up. And we're going to use these details to log in. So I'm going to come here in my start menu and I want to look for Git Bash. So open up Git Bash. And once you open Git Bash, the first thing you want to do is we want to try to log into our server. So I'm going to copy the IP address and to log into the server. I will just right, SSH. So this is the same way you log in on terminal. If you're following along on terminal on Linux. So I'm using Windows, as I've said. So SSH and then the user root at my IP address. So on Git Bash, you can paste by doing shift insert and then enter. And it's going to ask me if I want to allow this server into my hosts file. And this is a new server. So I'm going to type yes and then enter. And this has been added to your hosts file. So that means that it is a known server, a known address. And then I'm going to go back and I need to copy the root password. So I'm going to copy the root password, copy. And as I said, on Git Bash, you can paste by shift insert. You won't be able to see the password as you type it in or as you paste it in, but just press enter and you should be logged in. Right, there we go. So now we're logged into the server. We can try to update the server. We don't really need sudo at this point. So I'm just going to do apt update to check if there are any updates. Okay, all packages are up to date. So in the next video, let's come in and create. And we're going to create a sudo user. So the sudo user is a secure way for you to use your SSH. Once we do that, we're going to disable the root user so that they won't be able to log into the server. And from then on, anything that we do, we're going to use the sudo command. So everything we want to do, sudo update, sudo apt install, all that, we're going to use sudo. And we're going to do that once we set up the sudo user. So that's what we're going to do next.